Hey, Detroit, Michigan. I don't know if you can hear me, but hello. Google. Hey, Google. Volume 5, please. Hey, Google. Volume 8, please. We have a wonderful class lined up today. I've upgraded the lighting and the flags and everything like that. Okay, you can hear me. I guess I shouldn't say anything bad about anybody. Just getting everything ready in the class here. While I have this occasion, this weekend I'm going to be reading for my book in the studio here on Twitch and on YouTube. Class will start in just a couple minutes, guys. Feel free to talk quietly amongst yourselves. Hey, Mrs. J, aloha. Oh, let me get this TTS on, huh? Then I can be proactive while I can get this set up. I can hear you guys. Oh, let me get the speaker on. Two minutes, ay ay ay. Hey Google, play that Mr. G shit. Hey Google, play that Mr. G shit.
I understood play that listening.
Hey,
is that right?
I spent a while streaming on a Hawaiian vacation. Unworn white Levi's were covering his feet until he covered them with coffee and creamer. Mr. G, he's your average teacher, non IRL streamer. Mr. G, he's your average teacher, non IRL streamer.
Mr. G.
Hi, I'm Mr. G. Welcome to my class.
LOL.
Oh. Hey, Google. Play Beethoven?
Playing Ludwig van Beethoven on Pandora.
So, how is everybody today? Hope everybody's having a wonderful day. Today is December the 10th. Yeah, December 10th, 2020. Exactly 3 weeks left in this year. This year, 3 weeks left. 21 days left in the year. Only 2 weeks till Christmas. Till Christmas Eve, at least. How time flies.
Right, Peach?
Alright, if you guys noticed, I made a couple slight improvements to this, to the classroom.
December has gone so fast.
You're right, Mrs. J, it has.
Seth, you can send Mr. G, Moses, and he...
Well, if you haven't noticed, I'm in a good mood.
Avenue, Po Box 37305, Honolulu, Hawaii.
Mr. G, here, is in a really good mood. I feel like hopping down the yellow brick road. Maybe not that good of a mood, but I'm in a pretty good mood because I upgraded the studio. This is the first I've seen it with the new lighting. Let me just adjust one little ticka-tacka.
Little bricka-bracka.
Saw it, kitty caddis. This isn't possible during the summer months, by the way. There's way too many lights in here, you know, for summer.
Unless I had a cooling device, you know. The cats would be too hot.
However, since the temperature finally did get a bit cooler,
help Mr. G with the donation
here in Hawaii.
Stream elements.
I can use I can use the studio lights. The hot studio lights. I can even make them brighter too. Okay, so here we go. Pretty bright, huh? You can see me real good, hey. This ain't some low quality fucking EBZ shit, is this? No.
Set. Camera is shakier than Michael J. Fox.
Yo, that joke was uncalled for. That was inappropriate, offensive. Watch yourself. That's warning one. Alright, you're lucky I'm in a good mood.
L-U-L.
Don't encourage him, Mrs. J. So, today is December the 10th. Hey Google, turn it down a little bit. Today we are going to learn about the great state of Louisiana. I-S-I-A-N-A. You guys cut the class yesterday. Our state of the day yesterday was Oklahoma, and I actually misspelled the word Oklahoma.
Mr. Themer made.
Nobody seemed to have noticed, though.
Where are you, Mardi Gras beads?
Oh, Mardi Gras beads? I don't have them. I'm not the biggest fan of New Orleans, Mrs. J.
Purple Slurpee.
My two least favorite cities.
Hey, what's poppin'?
Hey, Purple Slurpee. You just made me crave a Slurpee. Purple Slurpee. They have those here in Hawaii. Slurpees are very popular in Hawaii. 7-Elevens are very popular here. 7-Elevens are so popular in Hawaii. They remind me of... 7-Elevens are so popular in Hawaii. They remind me of malaria in Africa. Because if you didn't know, malaria is popular in Africa. Very popular. So is AIDS. Okay, that's enough. All right, we've tiptoed the joke line a little too far.
OMG, LOL.
Okay, well, all right, that was just me going back against the Michael J. Fox joke.
Shoshans underscore new underscore all.
Hey Shoshan.
Sir. Yo.
Hey Shoshan, do you like the new lights?
Sir. That was inappropriate.
Okay, back to the lesson, guys.
So,
weren't we talking about something interesting? We need to stop getting so off of course. What were we even talking about? We were talking about something interesting before I made those jokes. My two least favorite cities. Thank you, Mrs. J. So my two least favorite cities probably have to be New Orleans and Las Vegas. And those are the two sin cities of the United States. The reason I've been to both cities, I haven't been to New Orleans since I was a little kid. I hate to break the cheery mood, but the memory I have of New Orleans isn't that bad. Me and my brother were at a shopping mall by ourselves when we were little kids. Our father and our sisters dropped us off at a mall in New Orleans for about like 15, 16 hours. I think they were hoping that we got kidnapped or something, which we almost did. You know, somebody came up to us and said they spoke to our mother and wanted us to come in the car, but we're like, what? Our mother's in the mental hospital, you know? And, you know, we were at this mall in New Orleans and we saw Naked Gun 2.5 in the theaters. That's all we had money for. He gave us enough for a movie. And then afterwards we were hungry, didn't know what to do. So we wandered around the mall for like 12, 14 hours. And then they finally came back and picked us up. And what had happened was our sisters were a few years older. They were like 14. Our two twin sisters, and then there's me and my twin brother. They had dropped me and my twin off at the mall in New Orleans, and they our perverted asshole father took our two older sisters, who were like 14, 13, 14, to the bars in New Orleans and let them drink. And so when they showed up to pick us up, they were all drunk and acting weird, as we thought it, but we were just little kids. We didn't really know what was going on. The only way we ate that day is we had to stick our hands in the water to pill out change into the wishing fountains. And then we use that chains at the food court to get a hot dog or something to eat. That's the only way that we even ate that day. And so looking back as an adult, like a lot of times some things happen to kids and they don't realize how bad that is until they become an adult.
That is a sad memory.
Yeah, but the thing is, I remember it clearly, and there were some fun times during that day. Like, we got to see a movie, which was rare. We got to eat at a fast food restaurant, which was rare. And another thing is we hung out in the arcades in the mall, and we got to play that Simpsons. And there were some generous kids that gave us quarters to play the Simpsons arcade game and then the Ninja Turtles game, where you got to pick up the potholes. I mean, not the potholes, the fucking sewer caps and throw them. And then you fought Splinter at the end. Not Splinter, you fought the bad guy with the mask or whatever. Splinter was the cat.
That's it. I love that Simpsons game.
Yeah, that Simpsons game is cool. Bart had the skateboard.
That's it. Manhole covers.
Manhole covers, yeah. So yeah, that was my one experience in New Orleans. I take that back. There was one other experience I had in New Orleans. So that was the time as a kid. And like I said, saying that story now, it's like, wow, that was a scary time. Like, I'm surprised. Hey, Google, I'm trying to tell a story. Can you turn it down? So that was a scary time. And, looking at it as an adult, it seems like it's a scary time that something bad really could have happened to us, you know, and it shows how...
Sorry, I didn't understand.
Hey, Google, turn it down. It shows how sinister our father... Hey, Google. Hey, Google, turn it down. It shows how sinister our father was. He treated me and my brother completely differently than he treated our two sisters. There were two sets of twins, me and my twin brother and our two sisters. He spoiled our two sisters rotten. On their 16th birthday, one got a brand new Jeep, the other got a brand new Mustang. On our 16th birthday, he got us a mattress. One of us got a box spring, the other one got the other one. That was a big deal, because before that, we had to sleep on dirty clothes in the garage.
A Google divide by zero.
Hey, I don't know how they justify...
According to Wikipedia, in mathematics, division
don't
by
do that,
zero
Joseph.
Is division where the divisor is...
I don't know how they justify their actions. Hey, Google,
be quiet. Don't say a word.
So,
L-U-L.
So, I don't understand how they justify, you know, their behavior towards us. I know you guys are making jokes and stuff, not the really appropriate time, seriously, you know? But, yeah, looking back, like, I know they have kids now, and they only have daughters, and they still live with that sick fucker, the one that killed my cat, the one that dropped us off in a mall in New Orleans, the one that used to beat us with a belt, the one that made us eat a whole bar of Zest soap, the one that would openly let them steal whatever they wanted from me and my twin brother. You know, one time we were on a trip, and our sister Carrie took a snowball and beat it up into a big ball and took it and threw it at my face. I had the biggest black eye ever. Nothing ever happened. No punishment ever. They would steal everything from us. Yeah, that's what I was looking for, Shoshin.
Help Mr. G with a donation through Stream Elements. https://streamelements.com/mrg.
Hey, Shoshin. I would still be giving this class whether or not you were here giving your two fucking cents. Do you understand that? Okay? If I could time you out real quick, I would, but you're not really worth the effort. Do you understand that, Shoshin? Like, you weren't here for about a week. You weren't really that many.
What the fuck just happened? God damn it.
Hey, guess what, guys? I'm taking a break here. Guess what? If you get bored or anything, only person you can blame is Shoshin. Because I need a motherfucking break. And I did not appreciate fucking cracking jokes during that story. So you get to look at my beautiful black cat, and we'll be back with these nice professional lights and this nice professional stream, which Shoshin used to always talk so much shit about my professional, the quality of the stream. So I'll be right back.
Sorry, G.
Back in 5 minutes.
Mr. G, he's your average teacher, a gone IRL streamer. Mr. G, he's your average teacher, a gone IRL streamer. Americana writer, got no education. I met him while streaming until he covered them with coffee and creamer. Mr. G, he's your average teacher, gone IRL streamer. Mr. G, he's your average teacher, gone IRL streamer.
Mr. G will be back in 3 minutes. Mr. G will be back in 3 minutes.
Mr. G, he's your average teacher, gone IRL streamer. Mr. G. Mr. G, he's your average teacher, gone IRL streamer. Mr. G, he's your average teacher, gone IRL streamer.
Hello, Dave London. Mr. G will be back in just under over a minute.
On a Hawaiian vacation, unworn white Levi's were covering his femur until he covered them with coffee and creamer.
Mr. G will be back in 1 minute. Mr. G will be back in 1 minute.
Mr. G, he's your average teacher, gone IRL streamer.
Hi, I'm Mr. G. Welcome to my class again. I heard some echo there.
Echo?
I guess we're not on anywhere else. Okay, continuing. I got a little upset there. Got a little off track. Today, we're... Hey, Google. Volume 2. Hey, Google, play Mozart. We got a little off track there.
Playing Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart on Pandora.
Sometimes I can get a little sensitive. I was telling a story, and, the timing was off. You know, sometimes when you're Brit LOL, it may come off a few seconds late or a few seconds early. Hey, Google, turn it down.
Nice.
So... with that being said, I do apologize for any haste action or any. I think I handled it. I handled that well though. I took a break. We had a breathe. I had a breather, and now we're back. We can continue class. You know, we didn't miss out on too much time, and everybody is still here and present. I think Shoshin should be issued an apology. I think I probably got upset at him and yelled at the camera. That's what I usually sometimes do. So, like I said, Chosha and I probably acted hastily. However, I think you had some ill intent. You had some ill. You had, and I don't think you should deny any ill intent. And when I'm saying such a sensitive story, I think you should be appropriate. Nobody laughs at a funeral, right? Okay, but on to a lighter note. I actually visited New Orleans a second time on my 25th birthday, I believe. Me and my twin brother, on our 25th birthday, Michael, we actually took a trip to New Orleans, a late night drive to New Orleans where it's legal to gamble. And where we went is we went to the Harrah's Casino in New Orleans. Let me see if I can get a picture for you guys. I think I only emailed it to me. Anyways, there's lots of sin in New Orleans, okay? There's lots of sin. Alright, so gambling is legal. There's also lots of prostitution, too. Alright, but I'll tell you that quick story when we're 25. And this is a quick story. It's not that much content, or at least I'm not gonna have it as content. So, during our 25th birthday, we drove to the casino in New Orleans from Austin, Texas. So pretty long drive, maybe 6, 7, 8 hours. Not really sure. Doesn't matter. And we went to New Orleans to play blackjack on our birthday.
So should I be walking on eggshells, leave, or be my jocular self?
Just be your jocular self, all right?
In a chat today, Ski Mask Andy said he thought you were cool, MR.G.
Wow, that just makes my year. Carrying on. So our 25th birthday, me and my twin brother, Michael, a.k.a. MCATS, we drove to the casino, Harrah's Casino in New Orleans. They have a huge casino in New Orleans. It's owned by the same people that own Caesar's Palace. Which also owns the Forums in Las Vegas, which is the highest profiting mall in the United States.
Smiley face.
The second highest profiting mall is here in my neighborhood, Ala Moana Mall. That's the second largest mall in the United States, and it's also it's the largest outdoor mall in the entire world, the Ala Moana Mall. And during times like COVID, having an outdoor mall. 4 or 5 stories, you know, their parking lot, the Ala Moana parking lot. I tried to explain that to Britain.
New merch is here, and check it out. https
and crazy rocket arms. I'm like, yeah, the Ala Moana parking lot is about 5 blocks. And they were like, what? No, it's not. I'm like, yeah, it is. You know, then I explained to them, it starts over on this block and it ends on that block. Some people really don't know anything. Like, when you go around walking around on this planet, you automatically somewhat assume that the person that you walk by knows what you know. But especially with me, that somebody that knows a very large amount of information, there's many people in here, probably the people that are in my apartment complex. Now, they maybe don't know the difference between a Democrat or a Republican, which I've met, you know, like artists and musicians that didn't know the difference between a Democrat or a Republican, and kids and young people that didn't know. But there's people out there that probably live around here that don't know the difference between France and England.
You can send Mr.
seriously
G, Moses and Keanu
here in Hawaii. It was the very first time I've ever went anywhere where somebody didn't know what where Texas
Hawaii,
was.
96823.
Yes, when I first moved to Hawaii. I met a group of people that did not know what Texas was. They're like, where are you from? I'm like, Texas. I'm like, Dallas, Texas? I'm like, Cowboys, Dallas Cowboys? They're like, oh. They were Micronesian. And then I said San Antonio Spurs. And then they're like, oh, Spurs, basketball. I was like, yeah, basketball. Anyways, I camped with those guys. They're part of an epic story about me sleepwalking with a fucking 50-year-old bottle of scotch. I've told that story before. Mrs. J has probably heard that story. Cody, you might have too. But anyways, I'm not telling that story now. We got a little backtracked there. Today we're learning about the state of Louisiana. So we need to hurry up and get on with it. As they say in French. Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Okay, so the Louisiana state flower is magnolia. And sorry about the picture. I don't like it, the picture there. I'll change it because I can. Yeah, you got a problem with that? You got a problem with me changing the picture to a better fucking magnolia? God damn. I can't win that. But you know, you gotta have like the art one because it just makes it look more professional, you know? Like I know my shit. This magnolia looks way better than the last one I had out there. All right, so. This is the magnolia. There's. My
I do, I like it, it's pretty.
One of my favorite Joe movies is Magnolia.
Sit. Hello, LJK.
And that's a movie, it's like a 3.5-4 hour movie. It has a lot of famous actors and actresses in there. Rosanna Arquette, Patricia Arquette's in there too, I think. Tom Cruise plays his only memorable role. It's a really great movie, and I really love the opening to the movie. That's a really thinking person's
film. I like that movie.
It's a really great film. It's got to be my favorite movie of all time. If anybody asks me, would you like to sit down? I always say, I prefer to stand. Yeah, the soundtrack was entirely done by Amy Mann, spelt M-A-N-N. And she's a female singer-songwriter in that genre. But she has some really great songs.
East was a real tough gun in that movie.
And her cover for the song, the 50s, 60s pop song, One is the Loneliest Number, it's one of the really great cover, one of the best covers. So I encourage you to watch some of those videos on YouTube. If we do a desktop stream anytime soon, maybe somebody will remind me. I do play those sometimes. The opening to Magnolia is really good. It makes you think about coincidences. And those are all facts that he talks about at the beginning of the movie. But once again, we're not learning about magnolia. We are learning that the state of Louisiana's state flower is the magnolia. And once again, the state flower, we also got to learn what the state bird is. The state bird of Louisiana is the brown swan. But no, it's not a swan. It's a pelican. That's why the basketball team is called the New Orleans Pelicans.
Dream Elements.
But yeah, it's a pelican. It's the state bird of Louisiana.
The new merch is here.
The brown pelican.
Check it out. https://.
Now, the brown pelican, it also makes an appearance on the state flag.
Help Mr. G with a donation through Stream.
Now, the state flag is one of the more interesting state flags that I've ever seen. Could you mind? Alright, let me put him in the speaker.
Joe Shuns _new_ all. Said, I love pelicans, they are adorable.
So, the brown pelican is the state bird. The state flag of Louisiana is quite interesting. I put it in the corner there. The state flag consists, it's also on the board as well, on the top corner of the board by my head on the video. The state flag of Louisiana consists of the state bird, a brown pelican, and also the banner that says Union, Justice, and Confidence. The pelican, it has three chicks with it in the picture. And I don't know, have you guys noticed anything odd so far? Well, it looks like the mama bird is, you know, feeding the baby birds, right? You know, which is a common, typical thing. But if you look a little closer here, the mama bird is actually biting her own tit and feeding her babies the blood from her tit. Yes. I'm not kidding. This is the state flag of Louisiana. Now, I know they consume a lot of alcohol in Louisiana.
I had to tell Christopher Reeves to get off his high horse.
But they had to been somewhat drunk or something to do this. I mean, think about it. The bird is biting its own breast to feed its chick's blood. Like, is it starving? Or I don't understand. You know, it's just, it doesn't make any sense to me. Like, why the hell, why don't you just have it feed it worms or something? Why are you feeding it blood? Is it a vampire? Like, god damn, what the fuck is up with that? I mean, it's some weird shit, right? The state bird is okay. There's nothing wrong with having a brown pelican on your state flag. But what the hell is with the pelican feeding its chicks its own blood? I don't know. But we're just going to leave it at that. If you want to research that on your own time for extra credit, I go for it.
Sir.
Right?
And what's with the airline food?
Because there's no good reason, you know? And what's with the airline food? Okay, so we went over the state bird, the brown pelican, the state flower, the magnolia. What else? The state tree is the bald cypress. Let's see if we can get, see if I can find some more information. Well, let's just go with some fun facts here, huh? So, Louisiana fun facts. It was founded in 1812 as the 18th state. So think about that, guys. There's guys and girls. There's 50 states in the Union. So there were 32 states after Louisiana. Louisiana was founded in 1812. You know, that was a long time ago. That was during the War of 1812. It was actually purchased before that. The Louisiana Purchase, kids, happened all the way back in 1803. And do you know who was very instrumental in the United States going through with the Louisiana Purchase? George motherfucking Washington. Excuse my French. But no, George Washington, former president of the United States, he played an important role in the United States with the Louisiana Purchase all the way in back in 1803. So once again, Louisiana Purchase happened in 1803. It was, for those of you that that are unfamiliar, the Louisiana Purchase was a purchase from France. France is a country in Europe. But the United States bought almost a million square miles for about $15 million. Can you believe that?
I'll
explain about the Louisiana Purchase. So the Louisiana Purchase was the best deal in American history, in the world history. For $15 million, which is nothing, the United States bought like almost a million square miles. Like, it's unbelievable, you know, the deal that they got. But Louisiana came in that purchase back in 1805. Like I said, and our founding father, George Washington, was very instrumental in the Louisiana Purchase. So that's really good that he knows that, you know, the United States went from sea to shining sea, right? Well, I guess, like, oh, he died knowing that. That's good. Now I can sleep at night. Anyways, I guess he knew that the United States was going to be the entire continent in North Carolina, North America. Okay, anyways, moving on. So we went over the state bird. We went over the state flower. We went over when it became a state. The nickname, this is a pelican state. It has a lot of farms. It also has a lot of immigrants. Louisiana has a lot of immigrants. They have a lot of farms. They used to, Louisiana used to grow a lot of cotton. They used to lead the world, basically, in cotton production. And so, you know, things do grow really well there. give you some more fun facts about Louisiana. So, the world famous Mardi Gras is celebrated in New Orleans. Mardi Gras is an ancient custom that originated in Southern Europe. It celebrates in fun just before 40 days of Lent, a Catholic time of prayer. So the name Louisiana, it's one of the few state names that isn't a Native American name. Louisiana, it's named in honor of King Louis VIII. Louisiana has the tallest state capitol in the entire United States. Yeah. Just straight a phallic symbol.
Daniel Cormier,
400 Justin feet Morgan, tall.
Regis Prot Rice.
34 floors. Louisiana is the only state in the Union that does not have counties. Its political subdivisions are called parishes. Okay, learn a few more facts here. The magnolia is the state flower. Gold, white, and blue are the state colors. The state motto is union, justice, and confidence. You know, Oklahoma's state motto is labor. Louisiana's like, labor. Number eight, New Orleans is where the first opera was performed back all the way in 1796. Wow. The United States became a country in 1776. So 20 years after it became a country, the first opera was ever performed. Boy, would I like to have a seat in that opera. Number nine, the Superdome is the tallest enclosed stadium / arena in the world. If you want to get a bunch of people coronavirus at the same time, get them all in the Superdome. Number 10. The name Uncle Sam was coined on the world of New Orleans before Louisiana was a U.S. territory. Goods labeled U.S. was said to be from Uncle Sam. Sorry, it's hard to read where I'm at.
Help Mr. G with a donation through Stream Elements. https://streamelements.com/mrg_live/tip.
Shout out to Dave London if I didn't mention Dave London. Okay, and New Orleans is the birthplace of jazz.
Superdome was ruined by homeless during Katrina.
That's what everybody thinks about. Well, I mean, that's what I think about when I think about the Superdome. I'm like, damn, man, there were bodies rolling around and shit. All right, let's go with a few more fun facts. Well, Louisiana, it's located at the mouth of the Mississippi River. You know, the Mississippi River, that had some clout, you know, during the 19th century. You know, before the invention of steam trains in particular. That was the way of travel.
Check it out.
Some of the major cities in the United States, they used to be right on the along the Mississippi River, all the way from New Orleans to Minneapolis. The Mississippi River is the lifeblood of Louisiana, having built up the land itself by depositing silt along its banks and poured into the Gulf.
You just made a sports theater interesting to me, a non-sportser.
Yeah, that's cool.
Shuns underscore new underscore alt. Sports asterisk.
So everybody knows we got to touch on the history of Louisiana here first, real quick, before we go any further. Let me go ahead and. Okay, class. I really want to touch on the history of Louisiana because it's one of the most historic states. You know, the other states. We didn't touch on the history as much, but with Louisiana, I think it's really important that we spend a few minutes and we go over a couple slides of everything some different things about all the way back to the 16th century, the 17th century, the 18th century, the 19th, and the 20th, and the 21st century. That's like six centuries. So let's go back to the 16th century. Like I said, another thing is Louisiana has been under more flags than any other state in the United States. There's been 9 different flags in Louisiana, similar to Texas. Texas has had different flags. Texas used to be a sovereign country. Texas used to be part of Mexico, and Texas was also part of the Confederates. Similar, Louisiana as well, except Louisiana was part of Spain. Louisiana was part of France one time. So let's go ahead and check out this slide right here. So, excuse me. In the 16th century, the Spaniards were the first Europeans to encounter the natives, but they only lightly explored the region and did not get up any major colonies. So there were Native Americans, and it was first explored by Europeans in the 16th century, before the United States was a country. Once again, the 16th century is the 1500s, guys.
We should give Texas back to Mexico.
No, but, you know, Hawaii should really secede from the United States. Now would be the time for Hawaii to secede. But that's a whole other topic. 17th century Louisiana, France took a much greater interest in the area, intending to use it as a base to lay claim to the North American continent. So this was once again, this was in the 1600s, and France, Spain, who had its colonies in the West, like in places like Santa Fe, New Mexico, and San Diego area. So Spain in the West, France in the Gulf, and England in the Northeast were all competing to be the dominant force in North America. And the English, when in New York and the 13 colonies, Protestant English, they basically won that. You know, the Spanish colonies ended up dying out, and a lot of French, you know, New Orleans ended up just being this melting pot of all different cultures that, you know, go from Creole to Cajun to French speaking to all different types of ethnic groups to its own identity, you know. So New Orleans, you got to be proud if you're from New Orleans, right? Okay, carrying on. In the 18th century, Louisiana traded hands several times between the Spanish and the French. So like I said, it's had a lot of different flags, and unlike other parts of the country, there wasn't a strong foothold, whether with the Spanish, the French, or the English. Now, some more continuing with historical facts. Like I said, we're going to be talking about history for the next few minutes and the history of Louisiana. I really got to clean off those stickers on the board, huh? Okay, that's for another day. So, 1541, De Soto explored the lower Mississippi River. He was the first explorer to explore what is now known as, Louisiana. Cavalier claimed the Mississippi River Valley for France 100 years later. And the first settlement was Nacogdoches, the first government settlement, in the 1700s. Okay, I guess you can't even really see that very well. So we'll go to a different slide. Okay, but that's the history of Louisiana here, and here you can see it on the map as we as I look for a good crossover here. So it has a lot of history. Some of the major industries, if I hadn't brought that up, is manufacturing, minerals, petroleum, which is oil, fishing, and tourism.
Said, I know all about De Soto. He spent lots of time in Florida. We have a shopping center named after him.
Oh, interesting. Shoshin, the Floridian, So, Louisiana, it's, it has crawfish. I've always liked crawfish a lot. You know, some people find them gross, but I think they're really good. Yeah, it's like the crawfish capital of the world. Speaking of olden times, this is what Mark Twain says about Louisiana. New Orleans food is delicious, as the less criminal forms of sin. Is as delicious as the less criminal forms of sin.
Oshans_new_alt. The former Floridian, not Iowa, Wisconsinite.
Oh, okay. So this is the first Capitol building of Louisiana. They had a really old school, like interesting looking Capitol before the current one, which they switched to this building. So the old one is still up, still a historical landmark, and then they switched to this more modern one. Now I think that's it for history. Let's see if we can, we'll go over some, a few more fun facts at the end of the presentation there. But as far as history goes, that's it for history. This is the part of the presentation where we go over famous people from Louisiana. This person is not from Louisiana.
Help Mississippi with a donation through Stream Elements. https://streamelements.com/mrg_live/tip.
So, some famous people from Louisiana would be the one and only Mr. Douchebag is from Louisiana. Who else? Who else is from Louisiana? Well, Dennis Rod Mann, also from Louisiana. Who else is from Louisiana, Mr. G? I don't know. Let's find out. Well, Peyton Manning, isn't he from Louisiana? Yeah, I think he is. Peyton Manning, a.k.a. I gotta poop, is from Louisiana. Anybody else from Louisiana? Yeah, Mr. G. Isn't Ellen DeGeneres from Louisiana? Yeah, I believe she is. She is from Louisiana. Ellen DeGeneres is from Louisiana.
Zip. Why are you choosing people you hate? Why not interesting people?
I love all these people. So, Ellen DeGeneres also from Louisiana. Who else famous is from Louisiana? Well, another very respected member of the Republican Party is from Louisiana, and you guys might know him as Wayne.
You can send Mr. G, Moses, and Keanu
Packers. Little MAGA Wayne is from Louisiana.
305 Honolulu, Hawaii, 9682.
Who else is from Louisiana?
Stream Elements.
Mr. G?
The new merch is here, PogChamp, check it out.
Reese Witherspoon, isn't she from Louisiana? Yeah, I think she is. Reese Witherspoon is from Louisiana. Wow. That's nice. She must have had a lot of fun out on Bourbon Street, if you know what I mean. So, who else? One more from Louisiana.
Evolution. Dead. LOL.
Who else? This guy. What's his name? DaBaby? DaBaby 20? I don't know his name. Little Baby.
Oshans_new_alt. Sick. I've got no idea, my memory doesn't organize thing by places of birth.
So, continuing on. So those are the famous people that are from Louisiana. Now, I don't recommend going to Louisiana, in particular New Orleans, but if you are going to go there, you might as well know that it's the Magnolia State. The state insect is the honeybee. Its capital is Baton Rouge. The motto is Union, Justice, and Confidence. There's about 4.65 million people, which makes it the 25th most populous state. The most popular TV show is True Blood. Hey, aloha, Cody. And I guess there's a lot of vampires there, right? And maybe that's the reason why you have such a freaking weird state flag. With, you know, I guess they're paying homage, you know, to the vampires. So if you look at the state flag of Louisiana here, you have a vampire pelican feeding its chicks, its baby pelicans, its own blood fresh from its tit.
Which is lagging so bad for me.
Everybody, class, did you hear? Twitch is lagging bad for Cody. Let's all send positive vibes towards his Wi-Fi.
Shuns underscore new underscore alt. Sir, that flag is beautiful. Davalundan. Sir.
Thank you, Cody.
Okay for me.
I like it when people say that I'm beautiful. It makes me feel good. So, class, I generally have a Coke or a Pepsi to drink. And I don't seem to have one. Hey, Google, pause music. And I don't think I have one either. I may have taken one and thrown it in the back of the cabinet, possibly. But I think I already drank that one, actually.
Go shuns underscore new underscore alt. Set. Flag not. Well, never mind.
So guys, I'm going to be right back. I'm just going to grab a drink. And Lucky will keep you company. Just give me 1 second.
Education. I spent him while streaming on a Hawaiian vacation. Unworn white Levi's were covering his femur until he covered them with coffee and creamer. Mr. G, Mr. G, Mr. G, Mr. G, he's your average teacher, non-IRL streamer. Mr. G, Mr. G, Mr. G, Mr. G, he's your average teacher, non-IRL streamer.
Hey guys, sorry about that. I had to get something to drink. It's really hot back here, and I couldn't find a soda. I found this Arizona, which apparently is already opened. It must have opened in my bag on accident. I didn't open this though. That's so weird. What should I do? Should I drink it? Was it open and leaked? God damn it. I guess it should be safe.
Abelunden. Se. Adam.
Well, I mean, what would you guys do? I mean, I want a drink. I'm taking the risk.
Abelunden.
It's fine.
Sir. It's fine.
Okay. Where were we? Well, New Orleans is known for a lot of things. When you hear New Orleans in modern times, you think of Katrina. Katrina, almost 2,000 people died in Katrina. I think it was about 1,800 deaths. And one of the main reasons was because lack of a fast response from the United States government. And that's something that you see over and over in the history of the United States, including now. Including now, we're not going to get into politics, but a lot of people, a lot of politicians on both sides, some leading members of the Senate and some leading members of the House, the leading members of Congress have really let the American people down, similar to what they did to the people of New Orleans during Katrina. All right, so as far as the history of New Orleans, we went over. It's more than any other state. It has just as much lengthy history, from the 1500s to the 1600s to the 1700s, if not more history. Nine flags have flown over Louisiana. Let's see if we can put a few of them on here. Well, this right here, this flag that I put on here, this is the flag of New Orleans. So this is a flag in Louisiana. This is the current New Orleans flag. They're big on flags, if you didn't notice. But, like I said, Louisiana, the state of Louisiana, has had many different flags. This is its current flag, right? The one we've covered already. But also, I'll show a couple more of their flags. We have this French flag of the state of Louisiana, which has, you know, the French blue, red, blue, and white. Very nice. It also has that New Orleans symbol. That's like the state symbol right there. You know, and it's very recognizable in the top right. It's the same symbol as the New Orleans Saints football team, and you see it also on the New Orleans flag as well. So that was the French Louisiana flag. See, show one more flag, I think.
Sir, Flores.
So this is the updated flag, you know, that's the alternative flag. A lot of people don't like the.
I think that's how it's called.
A lot of people don't like the pelican feeding its chicks blood. So this flag is an alternative to that, which is taking over as the regular New Orleans flag. All right. And so those are the flags that I have with me today. Once again, New Orleans, they're the only state in the United States that does not have countries. They have parishes. And in those parishes, those are basically the cities as well. The cities are the parishes. So you see on this graphic here, you know, each parish is the same size of a county, and instead of having, you know, cities or whatever, it's just, you know, a particular parish. So also, Louisiana, it's supposed to be the place of sin. So if you're interested in sin, you know, I would suggest that you go there. You know, the French Quarter is the main tourist spot.
_new_alt.
The French Quarter.
Where?
And also, you know, there's a lot of crazy stuff going on there. You know, you wouldn't believe it. But, you know, like I said, it's not for me. You know, it's a place for sin. Here's a Harry Connick Jr. quote. I actually met Harry Connick Jr. once. But he says, he's from New Orleans. New Orleans is a city of paradox. Sin, salvation, sex, sanctification. I don't even know what the hell that is. so intertwined yet so separate. All right, well, you know, it's Sin City, so I went ahead and pulled up some different sins here. If you guys are wondering what exactly is a sin,
you can send Mr. G, Moses, and he
on the left column, we have mental attitude sins. On the middle column, we have sins of the tongue. And on the far right column, we have obvious overt sins. Some of the mental attitude sins that we may not be aware are sins. Just a few of them are arrogance, fear, worry, anger, guilt, bitterness, hate, judging, revenge, implacability, jealousy, sexual lust, approbation lust, power lust, money lust, insolence, impatience, prejudice, self-pity, self-righteous, hypocrisy, and finally, envy. What is insolence again? I'm sorry, I forgot. Hey, Google. What is insolence?
Help Mr. G with a donation through Stream Elements. https://streamelements.com/mrg_live/dip
No, Google, that's fine. So yeah, insolence is just being an asshole. Okay, sense of the tongue. Gossiping, lying, blasphemy, perjury, maligning, boasting, criticism, shoshan, ridiculing, sarcasm, interrupting, shoshan, whining, flattery, complaining, arguing, and excuse make.
Said, according to these lists, you're a sinner.
Yeah, according to this list, we all are sinners, Shoshan. All right, the finally overt sins, sins that were obviously sins, are murder, stealing, disobedience, adultery, rape, fornication, incest, bestiality, homosexuality, I don't even know what that is, pederasty, but it's got the peed, so I'm guessing what that is. Voyeurism, so even watching porn is a sin. Necrophilia, there goes my Friday night. Drunkenness, trespassing, what the fuck? Cheating, cowardness, snooping, drug abuse, child abuse, extortion, treason, and revenge.
Said, it's what you think it is.
So, continuing with sin. Who will Jesus destroy? Fornicators, adulterers, idlers, people that have idols, homosexuals, sodomites, thieves, covetous, drunkards, revelers, cowardly, unbelieving, murderers, sexually immoral, sorcerers, druggies, that's funny, druggies.
Hey, bitches. We're going to be destroyed by Satan.
Yeah.
Me
and you.
Or
Jesus, I mean.
Hypocrites.
Hey, Peachy. Don't worry, I'll be there for you with the brimstone. Me and Peach are going to be destroyed for our sins. You're purring loud.
Can you hear her purr?
It is the sweetest. I would go to hell for you. I'd go to hell and back for you, Peaches.
So, that's interesting. I thought I'd pull up the Bible part because, you know, everybody's celebrating the sin of New Orleans. So, you know, it's kind of like,
I don't like sinners, I like geese.
But yeah, a few more things, wrap things up here in the next 10, 15 minutes. New Orleans is known for its Creole food and its Cajun food. There's a difference between Creole and Cajun. They're both actually known as ethnicities, which is rare. And the ethnicities come from French, European, African, West African, and also Native American areas. And they date back all the way, the Creole language and the Creole people. They have to do with Florida as well. And I mean, not Florida, but yeah, they are in Florida, but Canada too. And they date back all the way to New Orleans founding. And also that goes for the French speaking part of Canada as well. I don't know if we have any Canadians in the class today, or if you're watching on YouTube right now, go ahead and leave a comment if you're a Canadian and you know about French Canadian, because I know there is a lot of
Oh, he has a yawn. Logo, logo. You got a good yawn. That's a good yawn. Who taught you to yawn like that?
You alright? I learned it by watching you.
Oh, that's okay. I like to yawn too. Let me kiss you.
Love you, Peach. Isn't Peach the cutest, sweetest kitty?
Check out Peach.
Like, I love her so much. I mean, how could you not? Mrs. J, don't you love peaches? Anyways.
Well, not in the computer, Peach.
So I have my new Instagram on the screen here. go ahead and, I upload on there more than other places. Once again, I don't want to get off topic. I want to say a little bit more about Louisiana. The biggest school in Louisiana is LSU, which stands for Louisiana State University. It has over 30,000 students. The whole state of Louisiana is pretty small. It only has 4 million. So it's right there with Oklahoma and, it has a little more people than Kansas and some of the other states we've gone over, but it has less than 10 electoral votes. If you're wondering if it's Democrat or Republican, it went for Trump. It's not necessarily a swing state, but there are large pockets of places that vote Democratic in its two largest cities. Its largest city is New Orleans. The population is something like 500,000, not even that really. It's 400,000, 300,000. Hey Google, what's the population of New Orleans? Hey Google. Volume 9. Hey Google, what's the population of New Orleans?
In 2018, its population was 391,006.
Thank you. So, less than 500,000, like I said, 400,000 people. That's not a large city. And considering the amount of crime that happens in New Orleans, its second largest city is the state capital, Baton Rouge, which has just over 200,000 people. Hey Google, what's the population of Baton Rouge?
In 2018, the population of Baton Rouge, Louisiana was 221,599.
Okay, yeah, so about 200,000 people in Baton Rouge and its capital, which is not very much at all. So it has a huge high crime rate. The Mississippi River, it starts in New Orleans and it goes all the way up to Canada. Basically, that's the dividing point. From the west side of the United States to the east side of the United States. Two-thirds of the United States lives on the east side of the Mississippi River. Also, two-thirds of the crime in the United States happens on the east side of the Mississippi River. I've actually never been east of the Mississippi River. I've been to New Orleans, I've been to Minneapolis, but I've never been east of that river. I never plan to either. If I do, I'll go the long way around. I'm here in Hawaii, so I would go west all the way to the other side of North America. And then I would get closer and closer to the river, and then I would find someone and I would tell them, I'd be like, hey, I've never been east of the Mississippi River. And they'd look at me like I'm crazy. They're like, you're east of the Mississippi River right now. And I'd be like, no, I'm not. You know, I've never been east, you know, of the Mississippi River, at least not right east anyways. You go around the world, that'd be kind of pointless. That'd be a long way to go for a simple joke, right? I shouldn't even have brought that up. Anyways, Continuing with just a few more tidbits about Louisiana. There's French-speaking people there. They're known for their Cajun cooking, jambalaya. What's some more Cajun food? I don't know. I've never been there, but Emerald, that chef is from there, Louisiana. It's known for some of its best cooking. They have their own like Creole people, and they have Cajun people. That's their own ethnic group. Cajun people are all in Eastern Canada as well. Mardi Gras dates back, we saw on that slide, all the way back to 1699 when it was first celebrated in New Orleans. So in the 1600s, think about that. You know, if you're living in 1699, you imagine, I wonder what life 100 years from now is going to be. What, 1799? Not much better, right? Oh, 1699 to 1799. Big deal, you know. 1799 to 1899. Well, that's a big deal. 1899 to 1999. That's a big deal. You know, 1899, riding horses. 1999, flying cars. Or, you know, almost, right? So, history, we went over history of New Orleans. They have a long-standing history, more than any other state, with the exception of Texas or Hawaii, that I know about. They have more culture there than any other state, with the acceptance of Texas or Hawaii. You know, I don't plan on going there or anything, but I can be fair. They do have more culture, more history, and more diversity. They have more diversity than Hawaii and Texas, too, I would say. They have more culture is the most important thing. They have as much culture as Texas and Hawaii, and as far as states go. So, anything else? We talked about Katrina. We talked about Mardi Gras. Everybody knows Mardi Gras comes from Ash Wednesday and Fat Tuesday. Fat Tuesday is the day before Ash Wednesday. Ash Wednesday is the first day of Lent. So on Lent,
peaches. My peaches trying to destroy the classroom. Peaches, why you going to destroy the classroom?
So, Fat Tuesday and then Ash Wednesday is the next day. Catholics for Lent, you know, when you see people with the ash cross on their head, you're supposed to give something up for Lent for 40 days. So, you know, Fat Tuesday is the day that you're supposed to get drunk or, you know, eat gratuitously and have a good old time until you quit whatever it is you're gonna quit for 40 days. So
what are you gonna quit for then?
Nothing.
That's good.
So what else? Well, we talked about the French influence. New Orleans was under French control in the 1700s. So before United States was a country, I covered that briefly, but I'll just touch on it again. Louisiana was part of France and Spain before the United States was a country. The United States became a country in 1776, and immediately it had its eyes on the rest of North America to the Pacific Ocean. It was just a matter of how they were going to obtain that. And the founding father, George Washington, played a critical part and making the Louisiana Purchase a reality.
Right, peaches.
So, with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed the lesson today. I was going to cover sports teams. Louisiana, the main sports team, is the football team, the Saints, the New Orleans Saints. They play in the Superdome. They were the only professional sports team in the whole state before the recent New Orleans Pelicans, which doesn't have the most interesting name. The states that border Louisiana are just four: Arkansas, Mississippi, actually three, just Arkansas, Mississippi, and Texas. They only have three bordering states, and then the Gulf of Mexico in the south. They have a lot of good seafood in Louisiana. And that's mixed into, you know, the different Cajun cooking and the different Creole. Another thing is, you know, they have more visitors, to the area there. However, it is a really dangerous place. And there's no getting around them. You know, for the amount of people that live in New Orleans and the amount of people that live in Louisiana, it's a very dangerous place. Also, the history thing that I didn't touch on was New Orleans was a slave post. It was one of the largest slave trading posts in the United States for, you know, a century. New Orleans was where you would go if you wanted to participate in the transatlantic slave trade. You know, there was ships would come in from the Gulf of Mexico, and New Orleans was a major port of entry for slave ships. So, also, the state of Louisiana was one of the top importers of cotton. I don't know if they still grow cotton. But yeah, they did at one time. They were the largest importers of cotton. Cotton growth basically stopped in East Texas. In Houston area, the East Texas, they grew cotton there. But the climate changes once you get into the central part of the state of Texas, like San Antonio, Austin, more to the hill country where you can't grow cotton like you can in East Texas. So cotton was grown in the South from Delaware and Virginia all the way down south and all the way west of there to Louisiana. That's basically where the Deep South ended in Louisiana. And believe it or not, that was the wealthiest part of the United States for almost 100 years. And the North was very, the North, yes, they were abolitionists. They were against slavery, but they weren't, but they also were very wearisome of, and they had their eye on the South because the South had a free labor force with slavery. And the South was able to profit so much from there. All the money in the United States was in the South, and that made people up north very wearisome of the South. And so it's not ironic, but it's that's a simple change of twist of fate, where the South is now the poorest part of the United States. Right? It used to be the wealthiest part. Now it's the poorest part. Okay, so that was New Orleans. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you're watching on YouTube, give it a thumbs up. If this is your first time seeing me, my name is Mr. G. I do a live teaching stream on Twitch Monday through Friday. So check that out if you're watching this on YouTube. And also don't forget to subscribe to the channel. If you're just looking at a state, this is part of a playlist. I'm doing every state. Once I'm done with every state, I'm going to move on to every country. And if you don't like that, tough. All right, I do like it. I enjoy learning and I enjoy teaching, and all of you are welcome here. This is a service that I provide for free for you watching, and it's something that I used to charge, you know, $25 to $50 an hour. So you're in first, right? Okay, so tomorrow's state, we're gonna move on. Tomorrow's state, north of Louisiana, is... Well, north of Louisiana is Missouri, or Arkansas. Shout out to Super Roofer. So tomorrow's state is going to be Arkansas. And next week, then we'll move on to Missouri, Iowa, Minneapolis, and then further down south again to Mississippi, Tennessee, until we cover every single state. All right. So as I like to do, I guess the free TDS has been off, so sorry about that. I guess the speaker's off too. Sometimes I just went off on a tangent there talking, huh? So we'll find the state song of Louisiana. And if you guys are wondering, this weekend, there's no class this weekend, but I will be reading from my book, Gonzo Education, live on YouTube and Twitch. That'll be done in the classroom here, live on Twitch, and then in my studio with the green screen, live on YouTube. So I encourage you to come and say hi for the live book reading this weekend. So the Louisiana state song is actually You Are My Sunshine. Alright guys, everybody, have a good night. Here's to Louisiana, Shoshin. Special thanks, Dave London.
As I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms.
And everybody, I hope you enjoy the state. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Class dismissed.
And I hung my head and cried.
Good night, Shoshin.
My sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you.
Sip.
Please don't take my son.
Join Mr. G's Discord. https://discord.gg/cs3r2eyes.
Skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Shattered all my dreams. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You never know.
All right, guys, everybody, have a nice night. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Class dismissed. Aloha.
You my sunshine.